I want to start with a disclaimer for this particular video, because this video is for two sets of people. Number one is the category of people who already have a home theater system but want to enhance their sound experience, and the number two type of people are the ones who are actually out there to buy home theater and want to understand few things prior so that when their system comes home, they know what to do with it. So this video is for these two set of people. If you are one of those, I insist you to hit the like button right now so that I know that this video has been consumed by the right set of people who are required to watch this video. Hello everyone, my name is Tanmay Mehta, your home theater guy from Touchwood Automations, and in this particular video, I am actually going to help you understand a basic speaker setup that you need to try with your system, either if you have it right now or if you are planning to buy, so that your experience goes to the next level. Now before I jump into these things, let me just introduce myself. So I have been basically in this industry since last 8.5 years, and I have helped more than thousands of people across India set up their right home theater systems. And I have been doing this with my team from here in Pune, and with the last 8.5 years of experience, what we have realized is that very few people know what to buy, very few people know how should they go about it, and lastly, very few people know how to use the system. And in this particular channel, my sincere efforts are to guide all these three sets of people so that you get your value for money and I eventually get my mission accomplished of helping each one of you make better, well-informed and correct decisions when it comes to buying anything and everything in the home theater space. But before I begin with my speaker setup, I want to understand from each one of you, what are the mistakes that you're doing right now, or where do you feel that you're lacking in terms of getting the best output of the speaker? Make sure to use the comments so that I can reply on each of your comments and help you understand these things more in detail. And now let's check out the speaker setup. So when you're buying a floor standing speaker, one of the common observations that I have had over the past few years is that whenever somebody buys a floor standing speaker, and when you set up it with the AVR, in the AVR software or the calibration setup, you always tend to put this speaker on a large mode instead of a small mode. And a simple reason being that the small is meant for satellites or bookshelf, but when it comes to floor standing, they are actually large speaker. So I need to put it on large mode. But what happens is when you put it on large mode, the subwoofer will perform less and the frequencies for the subwoofer will also come from the floor standing speaker. And that is where you may not get a best output or the right audio quality from the speakers. So if you just do this small setup change, wherein you change the speakers from large to small, even in case of floor standing speakers, and then go into the frequency management of that AVR's calibration and set up the frequency between 60 to 80 Hertz for the front two speakers, you will see a massive difference in your system's output. And to listen to that, you need to be aware of one particular track which you know thoroughly, play it on a stereo mode and then see the difference. I am sure that this particular small tip, wherein you shift from a large speaker setup to a small speaker setup, actually help you get the best output from your speakers. I hope that this video helps you with the right calibration settings for your speakers, and if at all you have given it a try, then make sure to share your experience in the comments below so that I also know if you're doing it right or if at all I am doing it wrong. So that's it from my end, guys. I, Tanmay Mehta, your home theater guy from Touchwood Automations, will see you all in my next video. Thank you.